Congratulations, you just won Powerball. What are you going to spend it on?
The world, according to Jon.
If you're lucky enough to win tonight's record-setting Powerball jackpot, you could go home with $1.5 billion. After the lump sum and taxes, however, it's closer to $550 to $600 million. But still, a really solid chunk of change. So what do you do with all that money after you've won? Well, statistically speaking, you're not going to win. 1 in 300 million are your odds of winning this thing. Also, just hypothetically, let's have fun with this, because after all, the lottery is sort of a fantasy, sort of a thought gamble. But if you were to win, and you were to take the lump sum after taxes, that 600 million or so is still enough money to buy you quite a few things. So number 10, buy a sports franchise. Most of the NFL teams are out of your budget, but hockey, baseball, and NBA, there's a lot of teams under the $500 million mark. The Milwaukee Bucks just sold a couple years ago for $440. And frankly, I would love to be a sports owner because that's the sort of dividend that keeps on paying. You would be wasting a large chunk of your money all at once on one purchase, but you would be an instant overnight celebrity. You'd be a sports owner. You could get into all the hottest clubs, all the best restaurants, and you'd have all these great billionaire friends all of a sudden. That seems like an easy way to get rich and stay rich. That is, of course, if your franchise is good. So maybe don't buy the Bucks. For $65 million, you can buy yourself a Gulfstream jet. Although, financially speaking, it's usually a safer bet just to rent private jets whenever you need them. Unless you really are jet-setting like every single day, probably not the best use of your money. If you want to spend about 30% of your earnings, you can buy the Playboy Mansion itself for $200 million, Hugh Hefner included. And if you need decorations to populate your new house, $9 million will get you a real-life T-Rex skeleton. I didn't know you could buy those, but apparently some museums will let you. If you want to get away from it all and have some privacy, $160 million will buy you your own private island off the coast of Thailand. Personally, I would probably want some contact with the outside world, but hey, you're a billionaire now. You can spend your money however you want. If you'd like to purchase the world's most expensive musical instrument, $45 million will grab you one of the Stradivarius violins, if the person who just won it at auction is willing to part with it. For a very small fraction of your winnings, $100,000 will get you a Tesla Model S. A couple more million will get you basically any car in the world, from Lamborghini to Maserati, so I hope you have a big car garage on that new mansion of yours, because you have money to buy plenty of automobiles. $12 million will get you an entire year's stay in one of the world's most expensive royal suites at the Burj Al Arab Jarmari Hotel in Dubai. For almost half of your winnings, $275 million will get you your own private 300-foot yacht with crew. If you feel like sailing around the world between your private island and Hugh Hefner mansion, this probably would be a pretty good way to go. And for the low, low price of only a $250,000, you can go to space on one of Virgin Galactic's upcoming flights. Now, these are all terrific suggestions, but does money actually buy happiness? Apparently, yes. According to Nobel Prize-winning psychologist Daniel Kahneman and economist Angus Deaton, in the United States, around $75,000 a year is the threshold in which money, quote, buys happiness. Anything more than that amount, it doesn't really make a difference on your overall psychological state. And much less than that, that's what you sort of stress out and worry about bills. So as long as you're making $75,000 a year or more, you're all set. Which is why, personally, if I were to win tonight's jackpot, which I won't because I didn't buy a ticket, it's a waste of money, I would probably take the annuity. $22 million a year to start, and by the end of the 30-year term, you're making $92 million a year. This is great. It protects you from making bad financial decisions. You get way more money because when you take the lump sum, they take out 38% right off the top, and that's before taxes. So in essence, the annuity option protects you from yourself, because let's face it, if you're buying Powerball tickets, you're probably not the best financial strategist. Personally, I don't know that I would buy a sports franchise or a private yacht or Hugh Hefner's mansion, but get some nice oceanside estate for like $1 to $5 million. Nothing so big I couldn't clean or walk around it myself, but something a little big enough that I could have 3 or 4 cars, I'd have a nice ocean view, you know, something decent but not outlandish. And again, if you're getting $22 million a year, a $5 million property is well within your ballpark of affordability. With the extra money left over, I'd probably do a lot of traveling by myself, like a speedboat, like a regular boat, not some 300-foot yacht, set my parents and family up with their own houses or cars or take care of all their debts. And then just buy a lot of toys, maybe build my own private movie theater in my mansion, build a really nice TV studio if I want to keep doing YouTube, but all things considered, I'd probably just retire from work forever. And then just live comfortably for the rest of my life, not having to worry about anything. That, to me, is the best way to win the lottery. Just to keep living as you are, but slightly better and comfortably. Don't go crazy. Don't spend it all at once. Don't give it out to every friend you know. But of course, there's always charities out there that need help. So with anything extra, you could throw to them as well, and it helps your tax burden. Well, there you have it. That is Powerball According to Me. Let me know your thoughts in this story in the comments below. But until next time, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.